What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And today we are going to take a look at Mafex's version of the Batman versus Superman, Superman. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. Now I've heard some good things about this guy and I've heard some bad things about this guy. So going into this review, I kind of know what I'm expecting, or at least I have an idea, but I got him for a pretty good price. So, you know, if he turns out to not be the greatest, I didn't really lose out on much. And if he turns out to be pretty good, or if I like him, then, you know, I got him pretty much for a steal. So, yeah, let's just hop straight into it. So for height, he stands roughly about 6.5, a little less than 6.5. So a little tall for the standard 6-inch figures. But, you know, I guess it's kind of expected for Superman. So moving out of the way real quick, we have some accessories. Hopefully it focuses. He comes with the laser effect eyes, and he doesn't really have, I don't know how well that's gonna capture, but let's see if he can capture right there. His eyes are like kind of whited out or yellowed out, and I wish it was red, but at the same time I think it's pretty good actually. Like, I think it's pretty accurate to Henry Cavill's likeness, so that's definitely a plus for me. He definitely does look a lot better in person. He comes with two just straight open palm hands. Comes with two fist hands that come on the figure. And he comes with two like stylized open-ish hands. Now, he doesn't come with much. I kind of wish he came with like his flight hands on like other Superman figures where his hands are straight like this. And then I wish he had like some true gripping hands. Because this, it doesn't really like look like a real grip. So that's the only thing I wish that came on the figure, or came with the figure in terms of accessories. Now in terms of overall likeness and build, he is actually pretty good, I'm not gonna lie, for what people say. Now I do have the QC issues that some of them do have, like this shoulder right here, it's really loose, so he doesn't really stay up. This one is fine, it stays pretty good. His body is actually not that soft, like he wiggles kind of, but then you have to actually do it like kind of hard for him to move around. But if you go like this, go like that, he actually stays put pretty well. His body, his rotation is like really good. Actually, probably now we can go into articulation. So his shoulders go up that much. Mine is kind of loose, so it's expected. So I'm not gonna really gonna mess with that side. Has bicep swivel on both hands or both arms. Double jointed elbows that go past 90, his standard ball joints on his wrists. He has pretty good ab crunch. It doesn't go that far. Oh, whoops. Oh yeah, another thing with mine, and I know the history of like the earlier Mafex versions, that some of the joints are pretty loose. So his head goes around pretty well, but as you can see, mine pops up pretty easily. So if you want to see him real quick, there he is. So this head sculpt actually looks a lot like Henry Cavill. I know a lot of people say that it didn't really, but to me he does. So he has pretty good articulation on his neck. Now if this thing stayed put, he would look really nice. But I mean, in pictures and, you know, when you're posing him, at least to me, it's not that big of a deal. You know, it'd be nice for it to be a little more secure, but it's not like a deal breaker for me. And then he has a ball joint in his hip, so he does nice articulation there, so you can get him in some like pretty good like arched poses with his back. Now his legs actually stay pretty good. Now, okay, so see, there you go, now it stays. So his legs do pretty good. I understand that sometimes the joints don't allow him to do full splits, but I don't really think I'm gonna do full splits with him anyway. So at least for what I want, it's not that bad. He has double jointed knees, which are pretty good. And then he has ankle rocker left and right somewhat, and then pivot going up and down, which I think is pretty good. I think it works for what it is and what you're asking for. And then toe hinge, you know, which I feel like should come standard with a lot of figures. But I know it doesn't look the prettiest, or it doesn't look the greatest, so I understand why some companies choose not to do that. I also forgot to talk about his cape a little bit, so I'm going to talk about his cape now. And then when it coinciding with the actual build of him. So his cape is actually fairly large, and it is there's bendable wire at the bottom. So now it's not the greatest. I have a feeling that it might take some time getting used to the poses, but I do appreciate the fact that there is a bendable wire, so he can have some pretty good poses when you get it just right. See, kind of like that. Not the figure itself, it's pretty in a bad position right now, but his cape overall, I think it looks pretty cool. It looks pretty windswept. So if he's looking up or if he's looking straight out, you know, like that, actually doesn't look pretty bad. Actually looks pretty good, you know. So yeah, so in terms of the overall build with the color and the texture on the figure, I think Mafex for the most part did a really good job. That's just me personally, but you know, I'm a simple person, a simple collector. So hopefully, I don't know how well it's gonna focus because I'm kind of using a GoPro. So let's hope it does focus pretty well. His head looks a lot like Henry Cavill. I love the texture and the detailing on the hair. And the texture and the detailing throughout the suit is actually very, very good. To me, at least, you know, it's texturized and not just painted. So you feel everything around it. And then the lines throughout his suit, like the sides here, across down his legs, next to his wrists, and then like the cut of the boot at the top, they're all sculpted so you can feel it pretty good. So yeah, it's actually quite nice. And then his belt is actually nice too. And then his S, I know a lot of people want to talk about it. His S to me looks very, very good. I feel like this color suits him, and I feel like this suit actually, you know, is a pretty damn good suit for what it's asking for, you know, Batman versus Superman. And I know Batman versus Superman wasn't the greatest movie, but I feel like the character designs were pretty good. So there you can see the QC issues at work where it's kind of soft and not really standing. Oh, there you go. See, so when you get him in some pretty good poses, it does take a little bit of effort, but when you do get him in poses, it works out really well. So height wise comparison, here he is next to the SH Figuarts Flash and the Mafex Wonder Woman from the Wonder Woman movie, who I got in my previous review. So he is a little bit taller than both, but they scale pretty well overall, and they actually look good. They're actually starting to come together, and I'm getting pretty excited. I'm still getting a Batman all the way. I'm still looking for either a Nightmare Batman or just a regular Batman from Justice League, not the Batman vs Superman one. I heard that one is pretty bad, so I want to get the Justice League version Batman. Sorry about that. And I know the Aquaman is coming out pretty soon, so hopefully I can get my hands on that. And maybe if they release a Cyborg, you know, and then hopefully down the line they come out with a Shazam and maybe more of Justice League, because you know, Justice League is pretty dope to me. So while I pose him a little bit, so the overall quality, he is not the greatest, definitely not the greatest, but price wise of what I got him for, he definitely works. He's definitely what I want him to be for the price I got him. And you know, I probably down the line will get the Justice League version, because I heard that one is like pretty good too. So look up, see, when you get him in poses, he works really well. He does pretty good. So yeah, the only major complaint that I do have is this shoulder being really loose, and then my neck peg coming off pretty easily. But other than that, he works really well, and I like him. I like the money or what I got him for. I like the overall quality, the aesthetic of him, and what else was I gonna say? And I'm drawing a blank here, but yeah, you guys get what I'm talking about. Overall, he is a really good figure, and if you can get him for a really good price, I recommend him. Probably give him a solid 6.5 to 7 out of 10 if you guys care for like rating charts like that. if his joints were nice and like tight and like sculpted pretty well, I'd probably give him something a little bit higher, actually, probably like an 8.5, just because I enjoy him pretty I enjoy him fairly well. And you know, I'm not one of those collectors who are super nitpicky, like, you know, like who are like, oh, there's a scratch on his head or like paint apps, like, because like, look, he has a little smudge mark on his hand there, but that's not even a big deal to me. So, you know, yeah, overall he's pretty good. Highly recommended if you guys can get him for a pretty good price. So yeah, that's probably gonna be it. That's gonna be it for the review. Nice, simple, short. Sorry, I was trying to say simple for some reason. But nice, simple, short, sweet. I did fix some problems that some people pointed out to me with my last review. So hopefully that is, I can see it, people can see it a little bit better. Now I'm still recording with my GoPro, so I don't know how much the focus is gonna work coming forward like this. I hope it does pretty well. If not, this is probably gonna be the last video I do with this GoPro, and I'll switch back to my regular camera. But I kind of fixed some of the lights. It's not shining directly on the figure, so if it is too dark, please let me know. And that's probably gonna be it. Thank you guys for all your support. Thank you guys for all the love. If you guys do want to follow me on Instagram, please go ahead and do so. Please consider subscribing. Please consider liking the video. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.